Hello everyone, Chidden's here, and today, most of the things I'm building, and what is it, you might ask? It is a wooden mansion. Yes, it's mansion, but in supposedly the tightest slot in the game available, 20 times 40. Don't ask me why I choose this slot. In fact, but I think it'd be much more appropriate to say, don't ask me why I just plan out like what. Actually, I just want to say one thing. I'm not the type. I just want to clarify this, the first thing. I'm not the type of guy who would draw plans before I start building. I'm just the type of guy who's like, I know what to do. I'm just gonna do it straight away. Yeah. And here, as you can see just now, I removed the pre-made ceiling just to add my own ceiling. So that it. Just, I don't know why. I just want it that way. Also, I want to bring out that one point about these ceilings where if you try to put flooring, it'll only be placed on the boundaries of the flooring. So, there it is. And here I'm adding walls for the second floor. So yes, this house has second floor, first floor and second floor. And I don't know what else to say. And here it is, almost completed. Yep, it's completed. So now, since it has three floors, which is my target, I'm going to put some ceiling. And yeah, I just started doing this. And one thing, I don't know what to say. I'm not the tough guy who loves recording. I mean, I like building houses in Sims, but when it comes to recording, I'm not a big fan of recording. So I just find it like a bit stressful for me to do so. Or maybe because I'm just being inconsistent and lazy, but whatever. Now here am I, adding the roofs. And this octagonal roof, which works well for the front. And here I'm adding hip roofs for the rest of the part of the house. And yeah, I have nothing much to say. It's just adding roofs. I was thinking of adding like this, a gable roof on that side. This now, as you can see, but I change it to hip because, if you ask me, it doesn't work well. And another gable roof. My plans is that, that wall will slide at the bottom part, the push inwards, and then the roof. It will extend outwards. And yeah, one more roof. Just so I can fill that missing gap, which I just noticed. And it's not that much of an issue. And it should be done real quick. And yes, there it is. Now the roofing's done. Here comes the paintings of the roof. And here in the roof trim, the dark blue, no, dark brown roofing. And now, after painting the roof and its trim, it's time to paint the walls. And it is, I like this trim. And did you notice that little roof here? I addition this now that it doesn't have a trim, but I will add it later on. It's gonna be part here later. Ah, there it is, added. Now it's time to go back to the wallpaper designing. And I don't know what am I doing with these wallpapers. I just put out whatever I like. And yeah, I have problems deciding with wallpapers what to go for. And as I said earlier, I'm not the tough guy who would plan the houses. I'm just the type of guy who would just open up the Sims and then go, I know what to do, let's build a house. So there it is, a dark, dark brown and the lighter beige brown, and adding the black color to it, which makes it with something like separating. Usually when I build houses, it's not always the same monotonous color or monotone or something. I just try to add as many colors as I can because I want to make it more interesting to look at. And after a bit of it, yes. Okay, not yet. Not fully done. I try to add like the siding wall, white wall siding part of it. Mars will be the most useless addition because it does little. And yep, making his house taller. Roof individually. And now it's time for the interior. Okay, not really. I usually do these things, deciding what the interior layout is gonna be, because I am not the. I don't usually build houses just straight away and add windows. I have to plan the what I'm going to add, what rooms I'm going to put before I can put the windows. Or is I gonna put like a tall window? Just let's say a tall window facing a toilet. And I'm not the type of guy who will add cushions, so I just have to be aware. This house has, I don't know, she has a master bedroom design and a bit larger bathroom. Okay, this house has 4 bedrooms and 4 bathrooms. I just like to want some sort of like an extension for the master bedroom, and there it is. And now I'm done with the rooms. It's time to add windows. Yeah. After dealing with the rooms, it's time to add entrance to the house and entrance for the lighting. A little bit problematic when deciding what doors to choose, and then I chose that door. And these three square long or wide or whatever windows. And then I put those little windows, the cheapest windows in the base game. And here it is. And this is supposed to be the kitchen, which I didn't talk about earlier. I just had some low windows and some bigger windows. I don't know what I'm going to decide on windows thing, because I also feel like adding like door windows, but I realize this is actually a traditional. To give it like more traditional base, and so there's white wall windows, and there's these 3 times windows at best, and this little unique window that I like. I don't know, so I'm sorry everyone, but I'm not the type of guy who would commentate for a living, let alone making videos. I'm just not a guy who just builds. So, I want to make it like a mini decking on this part, so I just had a door. Yeah, and those super fun parts. And then one back part. And tall windows to accompany it. And yes, it's not done yet. But, here goes. Adding the foundation, which is slider tools. And adding it. As you can see, I put the beige type of extension wall for it, but because it didn't go well, and because it felt like it should be thinner instead of like one bulge a bit larger, so I decided to change it a bit. And hold on, there it is, I'm changing it, and there, and it looks like about it for part 1. Here's the result, and get ready for part 2.